Hey guys, today we're taking a look at the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. We're going to unbox the phone, have a quick first look at Samsung's new foldable device, see what you get in the box. Obviously, you can tell by the fact that it's a very super slim box, but you probably don't get that much in there. We'll run through some of the specs, have a little look at Samsung's foldable phone. So yeah, let's dive in and see what you get in the box. Here is the box, kind of got a two-tone look. The lower portion of the Z teases the color that's in this box. I would assume it's going to be the cream. Yep, there's a cream. You can also get it in a lavender, a black, a green, and then there are kind of a couple of Samsung online exclusive colors, and there's a pink and a gray, all of which are pretty nice. Very simple box, very similar to the Galaxy S21 box that we saw earlier in the year. And here you go, here is the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. Let's put that to one side and see what we should get in the box. I'm assuming probably just a cable and very little else. Yeah, nothing in there. Here you get a little SIM ejection tool. There is a USB-C to USB-C cable in there. Nothing else. And nothing at all in there. So super duper simple, no charger, no earphones, you'll have to buy all that separately. So here is the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3 in the cream. Really, really nice color. That just looks really nice. Kind of a matte finish it looks like. We have the much larger cover screen than we had before. So let's just take this plastic bit off. Get a couple of plastic bits in. And there we go, here is the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. Obviously the cool thing about this phone is its foldableness. This kind of sits alongside the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. In Samsung's Fold lineup, obviously replacing the Note this year. So there you go, you have a 6.7 inch 120 hertz OLED display. You also have a display on the outside which is four times bigger, I believe, 1.9 inches compared to the outgoing model, the Z Flip original and the Z Flip 5G. You also got two cameras on the front. There's a 12 megapixel wide and a 12 megapixel ultra wide. There's also a flash there as well. So this is kind of your main camera setup. And then on the inside, there's a front-facing 12 megapixel camera. USB-C port on the bottom, nothing on the back. But it does support wireless charging. So if you pop that down on a wireless charging pad, it will juice up. I believe this tops out at 10 watts if you're wired charging, though I'm not quite sure what the details are wirelessly. So I assume it's not quite as fast as kind of some other phones around. So let's flip this open. Go through some of the setup process. Once the phone's open, it feels very much like a kind of traditional Samsung phone, maybe like a Galaxy S21. And you can't really feel the crease as much as you can do with some of the larger foldables like the Z Fold 3. You can definitely feel that crease coming right down the middle, but because of the way it's positioned here, it's not quite as obvious. So we're just gonna set this up on a Wi-Fi and we'll come back shortly. Okay, so as you're setting up the phone, you will get these kind of instructions on how to take care of the phone. Obviously, because it's a foldable and the front glass is super duper thin, there are some kind of things you probably need to do differently. Again, it kind of says, don't press the screen too hard. I'm trying to get stuff caught in it, blah, 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 blah. It's all kind of important stuff, and it's definitely kind of been one of the things that has held foldables back, in my opinion, before, that they kind of haven't been as durable. Samsung has fixed, well, it's tried to fix a lot of those things here. So some of the new features include, it's the first foldable to be have an IP rating. So this has an IPX8 rating, which means that while it's not protected from dust or anything, that's the X, it is protected for 30 minutes of submersion in water. So that's nice. If you accidentally kind of drop it in the bath, anything kind of fresh water, it should survive. Again, it's got this stronger aluminium, Samsung's calling it armor aluminium, around the outside. There's Gorilla Glass Victus on the front, and there's also an improved layer over the display that Samsung says is 80% more durable than before. So all these things kind of should help make it just a lot more durable and just not break as much as we kind of saw with previous foldable devices. Other new features here, it's running the latest, well, not quite the latest, but the flagship kind of for the early part of the year Snapdragon 888 processor, 5G, there's 8 gig of RAM, 128 or 256 gigabytes of storage. As you mentioned before, two 12 megapixel cameras on the front, a 10 megapixel camera on the inside, 120 Hz display. And the software will be familiar to anyone who's used a Samsung Galaxy S21 or any previous Samsung Galaxy S phones. Kind of once it's flipped open, it does feel very kind of traditionally Samsung. It's obviously when you've got it closed and in this clamshell format that it does feel very different. This much improved outer display, straight away just feels so much better. You've got kind of a music widget that you can see, an alarm, a voice recorder, timer, all these little things that you can do without having to open the phone up. This is just kind of a quick first look at the brand new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. If you've got any questions, let me know in the comments below and I'll try and answer them while we're doing the full review. And also, if there's anything you want us to cover in the full review, just let us know below and we'll make sure to answer those questions when we kind of spend a bit more time with this device, go a bit more in depth, test out some of the new features and whatnot. So yeah, that's the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 3. It's on sale towards the end of August. In the UK, it'll be £949 for the 128GB version and £999 for the 256GB version. It's obviously a lot cheaper than the previous version, which was kind of mid 1000, 1500, around that kind of mark. So Samsung has obviously worked a lot to bring that price down, and in doing so, it's kind of made foldables just a whole lot more mainstream, I guess. But we'll have to see whether this is actually really good and whether it is better than, say, just buying a Samsung Galaxy S21 in the full review. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you in the next video.